My dear Tacitus, you asked me to write you something about the death of my uncle, so that the account can transmit to posterity and as reliable as possible. I'm grateful to you. His death will be remembered forever. He perished in the devastation of the loveliest of lands, in a memorable disaster shared by peoples and cities. Your writings will add a great deal to his survival. Books and your words, my uncle, will be counted among the latter. It was at Misenum, the capacity of the commander of the fleet of the ninth day before Clenday of September, when between 2 and 3 in the afternoon, my mother drew his attention to a cloud of unusual size and appearance. He had had a sunbath, then a cold bath, reclining after dinner with his books. He called for his shoes and climbed up to where he could to get the best view of the phenomenon. Such distance you couldn't tell, but afterwards we learned it was Vesuvius. I can best describe its shape to a pine tree. Some of the cloud was white, other parts were dark, patches of dirt and ash. He ordered the boat made ready. He ordered me the opportunity of going along, but I preferred to study. He himself set me a writing exercise. As he was leaving the house, he was brought a letter from Tacitus's wife, who was horrified. He changed his plans. The expedition that started with a quest of knowledge, now called for courage. He launched the quandaries and embarked himself as a source of aid. He held his course directly into danger. Ash was falling into the ships now, darker and denser the closer they went. To alleviate people's fears, my uncle claimed the flames came from deserted homes of farmers who had left in panic. He bathed and dined carefree, or at least appearing so, which was equally impressive. He rested and gave indication of actually sleeping. People who passed the door heard his snores. They tied pillows to the tops of their heads for protection against the shower of rock. They decided to go down to the shore to see from close up if anything was possible by sea. Supported by 2 slaves, he stood up and immediately collapsed. As I understand it, his breathing was obstructed by the dust-laden air and his innards simply shut down. The body was found untouched, unharmed in the clothing that he had on. He looks more asleep than dead. And the walls kept tumbling down in the city that we love. I will say one more thing. This is one thing to write a letter, another to write history. One thing to write to a friend, another to write for the public. Farewell.